huge space, and it must have been quite exciting, quite energetic to be here, as this was a very big, thriving church in the early part of the 20th century, certainly. The church actually stayed here until the early 1970s. The patterns of life here in North Philadelphia changed. People moved to the suburbs, people got older. Eventually, Grace Baptist Church turned this building over to Temple University. They closed it because it was more expensive to repair and maintain and upkeep than it was to use it. David Adamany was president of the university and was one of those who was very strongly in favor of turning it into something for the 21st century and to use. And then Ann Weaver Hart, when she came, they were working towards this project, which was to make it an event center for Temple University, for the campus and the community to have an opportunity to see and hear and experience different kinds of things, not just arts and not just entertainment, but a whole host of things. That's what led us to where we are now. Inside the theater, the main theater, Lou Klein Hall, we have fixed seating on three sides. We have and in the balcony in the lower level, and so we have an extended thrust stage or performance area that can work within that. But beyond that, we have a stage that can be configured in different sizes, so we can add seating or make more stage space depending upon our needs. Significant things: if you look into Lou Klein Hall, you see the railing around the balcony. That's the original railing that was there. Mm-hmm. That was there. If you came to church here on a Sunday morning in 1905 and wanted to sit in the balcony, you would have put your hand on that railing. See them from here, but if you look, you see those green domes, those round domes. There are actually three of them up there. The center one is actually a dummy. But the two on the far end on this end, they're chimneys. And in the hot weather, early 20th century, on Sunday morning, because they would fill this church, usually, I guess, if they were 2,000 to 3,000 people, but they've had it more than that at certain times. But you think about it, they had no air conditioning, no climate control per se. They had gas jets around those two chimneys, and they would light they actually had a maintenance person who would go up there and light those gas jets, open up the chimney, and then come down here and open up all the windows to create a convection air conditioning system. And what it did was, just like any chimney, it pulled in fresh air, and of course, as it warmed, it went up, and it was heated up there, exhausted out the top. So they had air conditioning here before anybody knew what air conditioning was, The baptistry that was actually under the platform was about 40 feet long, about the whole width of that platform, but it was under floor. If they were going to have a baptism on a Sunday morning, they would take that up, fill that with water, and then the baptism would take place down there. But on special occasions, they could open up the wall behind where the pulpit was, the wall up where that you see there now, they could open that up, and they had a cascading waterfall that came down into the baptistry. So there were a number of students who said, well, I wouldn't want to go have a party and dance in a church. So part of it is our name, and yet the name is still an important historical meaning here at Temple. So for the time being, we're still the Baptist Temple. The things that you remember from your youth become very important to you. It's not that change is bad, because I think change is great, but I do think that you like to hold on to little things that remind you of who you were, where you came from. And there are a lot of people who actually went to church here because it was still open.